So, placenta is an organ which attaches the cord of the baby to the womb in the mother. And it is the organ which is responsible for exchange of gases, that is oxygen from the mother to the baby and carbon dioxide from the baby to the mother. It is also responsible for exchange of nutrients. The mother supplies the nutrients to the baby. The baby uses the nutrients, and all the excreta and the waste products are then transmitted to the mother via the cord through the placenta into the mother for excretion. So the placenta serves a very important role. Normally, placenta is located at the roof of the womb, or which is called the fundus of the uterus, or little by the side of the baby. In some cases, especially in early ultrasound scans, we may see that the placenta may be lying below the baby, which either covers the mouth of the uterus, which is the cervix, or by the side of the baby. In early scans, like 12-week scans and 20-week scans, low-lying placentas are quite common. However, as the uterus grows along with the baby, the placenta tend to move upwards. So if anybody has low-lying placenta that is documented on a 12-week scan or a 16-week scan or a 20-week scan, a repeat scan is always done between 28 to 30 weeks to confirm whether this placenta is likely to remain low or would migrate up. Mostly we will see that in 90-95% at 28 weeks or 30-week scan, the placenta would be away from the mouth of the uterus, that it would have gone up. It would no longer be placenta previa. In some cases where it remains placenta previa, that is, it remains below the level of the baby or it covers the mouth of the uterus, then there is a risk of bleeding as the pregnancy advances. As one enters the ninth month, the risk of bleeding increases. The bleeding is usually painless and without a reason. There are a lot of myths surrounding the treatment of low-lying placenta. However, one needs to understand that because it's a natural phenomenon, there are no food items, there are no sleeping positions, and there are no method by which one can cure placenta previa. Some people are advised total bed rest. Some people are advised that they should not go for a walk. Probably they should not even cook. But most often placenta previa bleeding happens when you're actually resting. It doesn't happen when you're working. So again, it is a natural phenomenon. As the placenta gets stretched by the growing uterus and it is in the lower part. Because if the placenta is in the upper part, it doesn't get stretched. It just grows along with the uterus. But if it's in the lower part, then it gets stretched as the uterus grows. Mostly the low-lying placenta in early ultrasound scans do rise up and normal deliveries can happen. Very rarely, wherever there is a low-lying placenta, even after 32 weeks or 36 weeks, then a cesarean section is done. Placenta previa is an indication for a cesarean section. And in these cases, truly cesarean sections are a life-saving surgery wherein the life of the mother and the baby is saved only because a cesarean section is done.